All right, Moab Pit, free power-ups, let's get it. Worst arena, but, you know, whatever. We have to deal. I'll see when we find a game. All right, we found our first game. Philip McRevice? Revice? Revis? I don't know, whatever. Philip McRevis. McRevis? Whatever, I'm not going to figure out how that's pronounced. I don't care enough. Mountain Pass, what are we going to use? I think the acid and salted. Let's go Dartling Boomer. Hopefully we get Tack. I think we got Super. Classic. We got Super Monkey 4th. That's just brilliant. So we're probably going to get no salteds early game because of the Dartling, but later on it'll pay off. Like, think round 6. We might be able to get a salted off because of the black balloons. Dartling can't fully handle black balloons, so we might be able to force some defense or get some eco. So he's not rushing me, he's not forcing the powerful darts, so we're going to get up the farm here. He hasn't gotten his up yet, which is because we forced the powerful darts early on. There it is, there's a farm. Quick shot? Are you going to quick shot salt me, buddy? Guess not. So, the reason I burnt the acid there is because I figured he'd have salted wounds, and I didn't want to give him the extra 100 eco. So, yeah, burnt an acid there. So we're going to start rushing with blacks this next round, get up a plantation first, and hopefully we can get some of these through. So, thanks to the Dartling glitch, I can't tell whether or not he's leaking, which is annoying. Like, really, really annoying. But, so he's starting to leak now, we're gonna use it. Did we get any from that? I don't think we got anything from that. That's annoying. We could have gotten it if we used it a little bit earlier, but we didn't. Maybe he has salted wounds too? So we're going to get up the second powerful darts just so that we can stop our leaks. I think we got a little bit of salted wounds, or a little bit of eco from that salted wounds after I stopped sending. Because I think he leaked a few lives to round 7 AI. So, alright, he's going to go for this. We might have to sell this farm. Yeah, we have to sell the farm. I bought the wrong upgrade. I bought this accuracy upgrade instead of buying the glaive ricochet here, so that's annoying. I think we're gonna glue. Why would you go with the glue on this map? Also, I don't like this side, it's a lot harder to micro on, so we might lose this game because of that. He's sending regen lead, so we have to keep in mind he does have the quick shot. I'm going to assume he has, like, Team Tower Stun or something like that. If he quick shots me, I'm going to power lock him. I'm going to send him a Camel Lead, force that Plutonium Darts upgrade. He's going to do the same. He might just quick shot some stuff at me right now. Did he sell a farm? Did he have 2 farms up? I'm not sure, I don't remember. But either way, I'm going to send him a rush here and power lock that. See how that goes. He died. Alright. Very boring game. I might even cut this out. I might not. Strapped for content, you know? See you guys in the next game. Alright, next game we got our boy Dill. let's see. Frozen River. Boat Boomer. And I think damage boost, super eco boost, power lock. Classic strategy. Ice 4th, that's a little bit busted, so We're gonna keep that. Go up to 6. I got one too many. It's okay, we'll just buy and sell one. This guy's not on global, or I mean not on prestige. We are, but somehow we're ahead of, we've got a higher global rank than prestige, which is bad. It's probably because of the, I got clapped at the number one player twice in a row, so that's probably why. Whatever, we're gonna kill this guy. We're gonna clap him, easy meds. So he's gonna go with the Dartling, so that makes me think that he has some sort of cheesy power combination, think super balloon boost, team power stun, or quick shot power lock, or something like that. Which is annoying, but this is BTD in 2020, so what can you do, you know? Boost only isn't out, so I can't play boost only unless I want to go into Ceramic Crucible, and there's no one good in Ceramic Crucible, so I don't want to. So he's going to force this Grape Shot here in a second. He's got the Super Eco Boost, so we don't have to worry about Salted. Come on, there we go. Got the Grape Shot up. We're going to let it catch up, because right now we're chasing. Put it on last for a second. Put it back on first. And then put it back on last. Put it back on first. Just to minimize leaks here. Might be worth it to send Pinks and go for this faster shooting. Put this back on last and leave it on last now, because we want to force that powerful darts upgrade. Doesn't look like he's getting it. We might have to send blues in order to force that, and I don't feel like it, so I guess we're just gonna let him greed until round six, because round six blacks will definitely force that powerful darts upgrade. There's super eco boost here, so he's used two super eco boosts already, which means his eco is probably like 375, maybe 400 by now, because he's been sending grouped eco early game. I'm not sure. We're gonna force that powerful darts up here though. I think he's got a lot of cobras there, so he might not even need it. Crap. Well played, I suppose. I don't want to send him group greens, because I want to just farm as hard as possible. We don't need any eco from the greens, because we're gonna get all the eco that we need from our super eco boosts. So, yeah, I'm fine with this. I'm not sure what to do. I'm not sure what I can do against this guy. So he's gonna go with an upgrade balloons. I'm guessing he's gonna upgrade balloons twice and power lock and send me rainbows. In that case, we get up a destroyer or two. I'm gonna power lock him so he can't power lock us, and then I'm gonna boost. This should defend. If it doesn't, it's not defending. Alright, we're dead. I'm not sure how a destroyer on boost didn't defend that. I guess there was just too much regrow. But whatever, that's unlucky. Alright, let's. Alright, I'm gonna quit. Yeah, I'm leaving this guy. I want to find some good opponents to get some good content, you know? Bye! Besides, he didn't have that many medallions anyway, so, I mean, probably means more to him than it does to me. So, I'll see you guys when we find a game. Alright, we got our next opponent, Luigi Vlogs. We have to disconnect a couple more people because they didn't look very good. One guy had like a total of 20k medallions, so not sure what he was doing in Moab Pit, but we gave him some free meds, and it's just so we could find a better opponent. Concrete Alley. This is an eco map, but I don't want to. Good thing he skipped it. Alright. Shallow River. I think Boat Cobra Boomer? No, we're gonna go Boat Farm Boomer. Super Monkey 4th. That's a good 4th. Because we're going to have a ton of money, so Super Monkey will actually be useful if it goes late. Which I don't think it will, but if it does, it's nice to have. Real ones know that the bonus clip from, I think it was 2 videos ago, was me with this exact same strategy on the exact same map. With the exact same 4th tower, just abusing Super Monkey. Alright, where's the game? What's going on here? Okay, that took a while. Real ones know that the Tech Terror micro over here was what saved me the game. So, against the guy who was going Heli Farm Ice. So, yeah. Fourth towers are dumb, but if they're in the game, might as well use them, you know. He's going with the boat as well. Let's see, we're gonna get up a farm. He's probably gonna do the same. Or not. Are you farming? Is he not farming? He might be egoing. That would be weird. Well, if he is egoing, Power Lock is a great counter to eco players, so. Gosh. You never see people eco on this map. And we're getting lag. This is just, you know, triple whammy enough. I'm gonna get up a grape shot here in a second. 54 seconds, we'll be able to afford it. There we go. We're gonna use a first super eco boost next round, and then we might have to get up a 1-1 boat to defend against his blues, because if he's ecoing, he's gonna be sending grouped blues. Let's see, use this. Can we get this up? I think we can. Because it goes around that bend once. And he's sending pinks too. That's annoying. And there's hella lag, man. Fix your connection. So we're going to get this up. Put it on close. We're going to leak a ton here. This lag is getting on my nerves though. We're going to leak a ton. Holy crap. Might have to get up another boat. 36 lives? How the hell did that happen? Well, I guess that's the price of greed, you know? But whatever. We're fine. We'll be fine. I'm gonna get up another farm here and use our next super eco boost to start around 6. Get up more bananas, use this. He's gonna send greens at us, which means that we have to get up another grape shot. So we're gonna do that immediately, because we don't want to lose any more lives. I think I'm actually going to get a 1-1 up. Yeah, got to get the 1-1 up, because we can't really afford to lose very many more lives. We're low enough as it is, you know. As I say this, we leak down, what, 10 more lives? Brilliant, just what I want. This game's not going very well at the moment. But, you know, that's the way of the road with eco. When you're playing against eco, I should say, because their early game is fantastic because they send you a bunch of group blues. I could send him some white, or not whites, yellows, grouped yellows, but I think it's better just farm. He's sending me yellows. We might have to boost this if he keeps sending. Do we have to boost this? I'm not sure. I don't like how far they're getting. I'm boosting. Yeah, he just did not stop sending. Because he had a ton of money because he was saving up round 6. Or round 7-ish with the spaced eco. So he had a ton of money to send a bunch of yellows. So he's got the wizard. So boat wizard. What's his third? What could his third be? Could be ace. Could be ice. Could be... what else do people bring? Might be tack. That would be a weird one. I get this up right here. Are you kidding me? Holy crap, we almost died there. Alright, I'm gonna send him a gigantic rush on round 13. This lag is just ridiculous. I'm probably going to cut this game out and just show you the way that this ends. Alright, we got our next opponent, Optic Gaming. That last opponent was really annoying because of all that lag. Hopefully this guy would be less laggy. Swamp. He's gonna have Boat Farm Boomer. This is a goat strategy, honestly, in free power-ups. Because the Boomer is really good against the, like, people who use Power Lock and people who all out with quick shot team tower stun or something like that, because you got the turbo charge. It's also really good against Cobra, especially on this map, because if you put a glaive lord right here, its glaives go like that, which is best for defending against the AI, because it goes against the grain here. If you didn't know that, then if you get a glaive lord up here and the glaives are rotating this way, it destroys balloons faster than it would if they were rotating the other way. So he got himself like a faster shooting and a crow's nest, I think. No, he got a longer cannon's boat, which is unnecessary this early in the game, which means that he's going to be down in money for the next few rounds. Actually, probably for the rest of the game, if I'm honest, because of that. He doesn't look like the best player either, so I mean, I would have DC'd him, but he didn't look horrible because he had like 1.6 million meds or something like that, so knockout. He's gonna salt at me, isn't he? Yeah, he is. That's annoying. Well, good for you, buddy. Good for you. Come on, can we get a banana? Thank you. Jeez, we didn't need to leak that much. I'm just gonna go ahead and burn all my super eco boosts early here because I don't like the way this is going. I need to get more defense up too. He's got himself a destroyer. Not the move. I'm not sure what you're doing. You don't need that much defense this early. Now, the reason I got the bionic up is because if he knocks it out, hopefully it'll come back before balloons are about to leak. If it doesn't, we can just get up another one. I'm gonna get up another farm here. Sorry if my voice sounds a bit weird today. I've been singing like really loudly all day and kind of lost my voice. We're gonna use our last super eco boost round 9. Hopefully we can get this farm up before then. Yeah, we'll get it up. 24 seconds game time. There it is. And we'll use this. 430 eco, so we don't have the fantastic farms that we normally do from the super eco boost because of the anti-stall, but they're not bad. So he's got the boat, the wizard. Not sure what his third tower would be. We'll find out though soon. So he's got the knockout. We need to keep that in mind. So if we get up like a turbocharge, he knocks it out, that'd be a big brain blaze. We'd have to get up another one really quick. So our micro needs to be on point for this. I don't think he'll be able to defend round 13. I don't think we'll be able to defend 13. He's gonna knock this out. Is he gonna knock it out? Nope, he's not. All right, so we're just gonna rush him. We're gonna power lock that. Ah, he damage boosted before we could get off the power lock. Well done. Toss him a well done. Toss that, get this up, and boost that to, are we dead? I think we're dead. Come on, live, 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 live. Don't kill me, please, please, please. All right, good, we're alive. All right, we can thank my terrible micro. I mean, we're not dead, are we? So he might knock out this boomer here. That would be bad. That would have been perfect, because I wouldn't have been able to react. This is a weird game. I'm not sure what we're doing. I'm going to send him hella big rush. A hella big rush. Just non-stop zebras. And he should die to this, because he doesn't have enough money to get up anything. Alright, he got the damage boost off. Well done. He might still die, honestly. No, damage boost OP. Alright, what are we gonna do? I think he's out of knockouts by now. We're gonna boost that. If he knocks something out, we're gonna get up another. Yeah, we're gonna get up one of these. That should defend. That defends, right? Okay, we're alive. We're gonna send him a Moab. We don't have any more power locks, so he's got the damage boost to bail him out. We're gonna use this. I don't want to pop that Moeb. I don't want to pop it at all. Crap. Come on. Jesus Christ, I hate everything about this game, the way that this game is played out. We're probably gonna need to boost this. So that's what we'll do. This is not going well. I think we all out him, but I don't know if we can defend a counter. I'm gonna send him one Moeb here, so we can afford. We're turbocharging here, turbocharging this. That defends, right? Please. He should die before us. He should die before us. Please die before us. Nope, I don't want to pop that Moeb. How? Alright. Well, I think our biggest mistake there was that we... Oh, he DC glitched me, that's how. Screw you, buddy. So I think our mistake there was that we sold our farms really early. Because I was panicking that he might fall out, knock out something. So that's just unlucky. So I think this is going to be the last game of this video. Are we recording? What the hell? Okay, we are. I think this is going to be the last game of this video. Fire X1, not a bad looking opponent. I know commentary today has been gnarly, but it's hard to comment and micro at the same time. Especially in free power-ups, because, like, there's so many different variables compared to boosts only. Even compared to R3 Bonanza, because you know you both have the same powers and towers, so. I should have won that last game, though. That was just dumb. The way I lost. I don't know why you're smiling, buddy. We clap you easy. Cobra is not... Like, we can defend Balloon Adjustment really easily with this strategy. Just need a couple of Glaive Lords up here and that defends. So, besides, we're just going to beat him round 13 with a decent-sized rush and power lock. I think we're going to need to send him reds to force some defense. See what he has. I'm guessing Boat Boomer Cobra. We're going to get this up because he stopped sending, because he's saving up for defense. He might be getting Mortar up, actually. No? Dartling. And you guys saw how the Dartling glitch works there, because as soon as you place the Dartling down, like, half of the balloons on his screen just disappeared. They didn't actually disappear, it just looked as though they disappeared because of the Dartling glitch, but we're gonna perfectly afford this, wow. So we sold that to get up another Cobra. I don't agree with that. I'm gonna send a bunch of pinks behind this to force that powerful darts. He's gonna send some pinks to force this Grape Shot. Well done. Put that on close. Might get a 1-1 up just because he's probably not going to stop sending because he's going with the Cobra. And passive Cobra tends to be like tons of space to eco while they get up Cobra farms. So so he's got the super eco boost as well. So he's going to have a fantastic eco just like we are. So we're both going to have a ton of money this game. But I'm going to outplay him because I'm better than him. So he's got a ton of Cobras there, so sending blacks will do nothing. I have to send a bunch of greens in order to force the powerful darts. And it's just not worth it. We're going to use our second super eco boost come round 7. And then our third come round 9. So we'll get ready to use it here. Come on, in the round. And the round, and the round. There we go. So we're going to get up a couple more farms here. I'm going to move this down a bit so we can place this better. Also, it's good that we've got this side because not only can I micro better, but the Glaive Lord is better on this side than it is on this side, because here the glaives go this way instead of this way. We're going to get up another one of these just so we can minimize leaks. Don't like leaking. Actually, we're just going to use this because we've got it. Might as well. Round 8's a decently long round, so it's not going to hurt us too much. We're going to send a couple yellows just to force some upgrades on his end. I'm going to power lock that too, because he's probably going to glue storm. Alright, never mind. You got the Glaive Ricochet up, so well done. Yeah, he facepalmed me. I didn't see the Glaive Ricochet when I power locked. Well done. That's a fair facepalm, honestly. We're going to send him a lead, because he doesn't have the red hot rings on that Glaive Ricochet there. So we're going to force that. Or we might just force a Bionic. Either or. Don't really care. So the question here is, do I go BIA or do I go aggressive? I think we're going to get up around 12 BIA. Yeah, I think that's the move. So at the end of this round, we're going to get up a BIA, and then we'll just go from there. That was horrible, Micro. Wow. We got a 2-4 BIA too, so that'll cook up money quicker. I think we're going to get this too, because I'm scared of a rush, if I'm honest. He's got a ton of Cobras. He's got a couple Dartlings. He's got the Boomer. I think there's no point in rushing him, so that's why I got the BIA up. Also, if you didn't know, Boomer is a great counter to Power Lock, which is why I decided to go passive instead of aggressive. Because if I aggressive power locked him and sent him a giant rush, he would just be able to easily turbocharge it. So he's starting the adjustment process now, so I might need to sell this farm. Actually, yeah, we're going to have to sell this farm for round 16, because the round 16 AI with balloon adjustment, there's going to be some ceramics in there as well as rainbows, especially if he mixes like leads or something. Yeah, we had to sell this farm. So we're going to get up another Destroyer. We might need to cash out our BIA and get up a Turbocharge. I'd actually just as soon boost instead of cashing out our BIA, because if we cash it out early, then we lose a ton of money. But doesn't look like we'll have to. So next round is going to be really hard for balloon adjustment, so I'm going to get up a Glaive, or the start of a Glaive Lord here. We'll be able to sell this cannon ship, because we'll have the Camo lead detection with our great Glaive Lord here, so hopefully, yeah, we'll be able to afford that. Put this one on strong so it defeats the ceramic layer, and then the Glaive Lord can clean up the rest. We might need to get up another one. I don't want to use my fourth tower, but I will if I have to. I prefer to avoid it though. We might have to get I don't know how long that's been up there, but we probably lost a bit of money because of that. I don't know how long that's been at 20,000, but we definitely lost some money because of it. But no worries, we've got so much money, it doesn't even matter. I think we need to get up another Glaive Lord here, so that's what we're gonna do. Double Glaive Lord plus a couple Destroyers. This should defend most balloon adjustment up until round 25. For round 25, we're probably gonna need one more Glaive Lord. Do I want to send him a BFB? I'm not sure if he has a misdirection up. I think I am, because if he does, we can just bolt pull it. Let's see. I don't see a misdirection on his side, so he needs to get up a misdirection, because Dartling Boomer cannot defend against the BFB. Damage, what are you doing? You're going to die to that. No. Don't die to that, come on. Turbocharge or something. Nope, you're dead. I think you're dead. Are you dead? Nope, he defended. Well done. Congratulations. Good job. I don't think I'm going to send him another one, because he can just boost it again, and it hurts our eco a ton every time we send one. So I'm going to layer a bit with the round 22-8. Actually, no, he's got a Hydro Rocket, so he'll be fine. There's no point. So you see how easily we're handing the balloon adjustment with the Glaive Lords. The Glaive Lord is it's slept on, honestly. It's a really good counter to balloon adjustment if you got a map where you can place it properly. So this should defend all balloon adjustment that we'll ever see this game. Like, I could sell these and we'll be fine. Or mostly fine. Like, that defense just even... Oh, never mind. Holy shit. Alright, well, I stand corrected. Maybe 4 defends everything? I don't know. Whatever. We'll figure it out. For round 25, we might need 4 Glaive Lords. But that's not a problem, because, I mean, look how much money we have. We've got a ridiculously high eco. We've got 3 facilities. We've still got our BIA, and we've got a ton of defense. I mean, Super Eco Boost is just such a great, great, great money giver. So we're going to get up the start of another Glaive Lord here. We're going to keep farming. We're going to cash this out and sell it at the end of the round. So, let's see. Cash sell. Buy this. Get up another one. Get one of these. We should be golden for round 25 AI. Is he attritioning me? I think I just saw some lives go down. Maybe I'm just tripping. Alright, whatever. We've got 5 facilities and 1,300 eco. That's ridiculous. I might rush him on round 26. Alright, never mind. He's gonna rush me now. Let's see. I want to defend this without using the ace. See if we can. Nope. Sell that. Get this. This. Let's see if we can pop these. I'm not worried about AI. We've got the Glaive Lords to deal with that. Okay, we defended that. I could counter, but I don't want to. Let's see if we can defend this, too. I think he's gonna die before we have a chance. Come on, man, boost. Boost. Good boost. He might still be dead. 1 life. Aww. Whatever, we would have defended that pretty easily. Didn't even need the 4th tower, but... Good fun microing. We almost choked that, actually. We almost popped that BFB. If we did, we would have to get a bunch of turbocharges on, but I wasn't worried. Anyway, that's going to be the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe. Bye.